Yeah. No, they gonna feel this shit.
What's good, family? We are back in the building. This is In Living Black. If you didn't know, now you know. As you should know, because you subscribe to us. You listen to us every week. Thank you to the faithful listeners. Thank you to everybody listening to us for the year when we was OTC. Now we're in Living Black. Bari, what's good, man?
What's happening?
You all right?
Chilling.
Yo, this is supposed to be our last show, but it's not going to be our last show due to MTA. This won't be our last show. We have another show coming up, so we're going to give you a double whammy. You know what I mean? We're going to give you a double whammy.
And that, holiday special.
The holiday special, right? And the next episode will be the 20th on Friday is when it'll drop. See, when I plug my laptop in, because I hate, that's why I don't even know how you turn off notifications on here, bro. Do not disturb. There we go. That's what we don't need. Anyways, so, yeah, we'll on the 20th, we'll give you a new episode, a double whammy. New York is terrible with the MTA system and stuff like that, especially for my brother here coming from Fall Rock.
Very true.
You all right? You look high today or something?
No.
Oh, okay. Nah. You might need some weed though now. Out of today.
I mean, I wouldn't mind.
Today, well, when you listen to this, the day would already pass. But today we're going to an event.
Yes.
Fedoras and Soul. I feel like you gotta say soul, but like, you know what I mean?
Probably, yeah. I mean, that is how Reese said it as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, Fedoras so well and soul.
Say it like that.
Right.
Like Don Cornelius,
exactly. So, there's an event happening. So, we got our thinking caps on.
That's right.
Today. It's about to be a beautiful thing.
That's right.
Free wine and stuff like that. I know he'll host another event. So, like, I just hope you guys hear me now. So, next time when we live before the event, we'll broadcast it. Right. I'm sure you guys watching on our Instagram follow that, by the way, at Living Black. So we're not gonna give you the end of the year recap. That's not what we're not about to do. Mm-hmm. We're not about to give that end of the year recap. He's gonna do that top 10. Probably artist of the decade. Our favorite moment of the decade, whether it's music related, life related, whatever's going on, bad or good. I'm gonna tell you something though, I'll give you a year recap right now though. 2019 was a rough year. Rough year financially, spiritually, mentally, probably physically too, because I remember the first time, that first day I went to the gym. That first day I went to the gym was brutal, cuz.
That was hilarious.
I couldn't lift my motherfucking arms, bro. That's how you know a nigga was like, all right, I'm out of shape. I was out of shape. Bro, I was.
Man, that next day you were sore, whatever.
Why you laughing at niggas' pain, though? That's what I'm
Cause, like, this man really hit me and said, yo, I'm having a hard time putting a shirt on. He couldn't get the shirt over his head because he couldn't lift his arms. Like, I thought that was so funny to me. Like, that was hilarious. I ain't gonna lie. I had a good laugh at that for a while when I saw that.
See how your brothers do you out here? So they laughing funny at your pain and shit? These niggas is nasty. That's why I don't tell niggas no more. No,
oh, knock it off.
I don't tell y'all nothing.
Knock it off. Come on now.
I can't tell y'all nothing.
You gotta laugh. You gotta laugh at the pain, you know what I mean?
Nah, son.
You gotta laugh at the pain.
Nah.
So I get stronger.
That shit was killer, bro. Almost died on that motherfucker, bro.
That was funny.
Yeah, man. Listen, I appreciate you guys for tuning into our YouTube, man. Shout out to the YouTube. Subscribe. Make sure you guys subscribe to that. That's In Living Black. Listen, In Living Black at everywhere, man. In Living Black at Gmail. Hit us up. Trying to get them, you know what I mean? Trying to get a little shout.
You know what I mean?
Hit us up, you know what I mean? But anyway, some music drop. Did you listen to any music?
I did.
This week?
I did.
What
I
you
did
listen to?
I listened to Kate Trinata.
Kate!
And I listened to Free Nationals.
Free Nationals! And it was just a vibe.
Very much a vibe.
This was a Friday vibe, y'all. This week of music was a vibe.
It was a vibe. I ain't gonna hold you. It was a vibe, especially the Free National joint.
Free National.
I was vibing to that.
You vibing to that shit heavy?
Yeah. If that had come out a little earlier, that might have made like my top 10 albums of the year. But it's too soon, so I'm not gonna do it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But like. The way it's hitting my soul was like, if it had some more time to sit in my soul,
yeah.
I would have put that in my top 10 for sure. I just love how that shit just feel and just flow. You know what I mean?
It breathes naturally.
It does.
It's a really wonderful project. It's just comfortable.
Hell yeah.
I enjoy it, real talk. Free Nationals, man. Listen, man, what song on there that you fuck with heavy, man?
I really like the T.I. joint, I ain't gonna lie.
Yeah, you know, I played it in a store and I was like, oh shit. Nah, I ain't know T.I. was gonna be cussing like that.
I thought T.I. got off on that.
Nah, T.I. did get off on that.
He did.
I like Westside and Conway shit too.
Yeah. Westside was in his bag. Westside was soaking some wild shit. I think Westside's a wild boy.
Yo, I just like that they did a mixture of everything.
Hell yeah.
They did the rap, they did the R&B, of course. They did the even like that. You heard that second song, what was it second or third song with J.I.D. when it was like, dum, 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 dum. That guitar, I love me a good guitar like that.
That should go.
That Daniel Caesar shit is sexy. I felt like that's how his whole album should have sounded.
Very much.
You know, and its impact did his thing, of course. Mm-hmm. The song what Benny sings with it's called Apartment is very great.
Mm-hmm.
That Chronic's song is amazing.
Love it.
You know, Sid did what she always does.
Sid always does that. That's a fact.
Yeah, you know,
Sid does always do that.
She set that mood, right? It was just a vibe on this whole project, man. I enjoyed it. I enjoyed it completely, you know?
Yeah.
13 songs, 41 minutes. It's just a calm vibe. You play that shit in the crib, you just let that shit go.
Clean.
You just let that shit vibe out, man.
You know what I'm saying?
I like when I let shit vibe. I don't really like, I got to sit with a project sometimes. Sometimes you don't need to hear that. I just like a good produced project.
Yeah, I don't always want to dissect a project, you know what I'm saying? And like really get into it deep, you know what I mean? Like, not all the time, you know what I'm saying?
Of course,
some certain artists require that, you know what I mean?
Of course.
But I love shit like this, I could just let it rock, you know what I mean? You could put this on repeat, but you don't even know, you put this shit five times in a row.
Yeah, because it just goes, you know what I'm saying?
Exactly,
bro, no. Because I listen to Free Nationals and Cajun and I probably both five times a piece. Because I did play it in the store yesterday as well. The Kaytranada shit, of course, because it was like less cursing and shit like that. But it was just an easy flow. Like it played within the tone of just like, it just is a seamless transition.
Yeah.
I think Kaytranada does that really well with his projects.
For sure.
His transition game is sick. But,
for sure.
Man, listen, man, we forgot to introduce the podcast. I'm tweaking. Let's get it.
Yeah, what we doing?
And Living Black, you already know the vibe. Let's get it. Thank you guys for supporting.
Can't really funky those. I mean,
why niggas do this shit? They swing their body.
It's all in the hips. You know what I'm saying? It's all in the hips.
It's all in the vibe.
The hips is where the most funk is at.
That's true though. That's
all my
true.
Funk is in my hips. I ain't gonna hold you.
I thought it was in the shoulder.
I mean, my shoulders is like where my activity is.
Oh,
yeah,
activity.
Mean?
Okay.
But my funk and my all in this little midsection right here. You know what I mean?
That's how you get that. That's how you get it. That's how you get in with the girl
on,
too.
Hello. Come on. Let me get my groin going.
You said you're growing.
You want to see Funk Towers 2?
Funk Towers 2 is hilarious.
Funk at the dark.
It's in my funk at the dark.
It's in my groin.
Funk after dark, yo. I like that one. I like
that's
that.
A fact.
Funk after dark.
Funk after dark.
Funky it up with funk after dark.
Ooh, hello.
Ooh.
What we doing with that?
Oh, we doing with that. Hashtag that.
Yeah, we got to copyright that shit.
That's,
you know,
copyright,
we
for
copyright
sure. That
shit.
Funky up with.
Don't
funk,
steal that.
Don't please. Yo,
don't
yo.
Steal that,
listen,
shit, man.
We know, listen, this is here first, bro. We gonna take you to the court.
Cause y'all niggas not even funky enough to steal that. You know what I'm saying?
Nah,
I know
sure.
Niggas not funky like that.
Come on now.
Be funky.
You know you funked it up too in the bedroom. You know what I mean? When she sleep, you know what I mean? Fellas, when she fall, when she sleep after, you funky it up.
When she knock out.
Yeah, you funky it up.
You funk that shit up.
Woo! When you knock her out.
You funk
listen, you ain't gonna knock her out every time. Let's just be honest.
No, of course not. The funk ain't always hitting like
funk,
that.
Nah, the funk don't always
the hit. The funk don't always hit.
You know when the funk hit for real though? Is when you play when you play music.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
You got to hit. Yo, fellas, I'm telling y'all, son, that's a game changer. You got to play music,
it.
Son.
You got to set it right.
You got to set it right, son. That's how you funk it up, son.
Mm-hmm.
And I listen, you could start with this shit, too, man. Funk that shit up, man.
What we doing?
I think this is a jam right here. Imagine just funking this shit up to this. That's some slow strokes right there, man.
Oh, yeah. Dangerous funk.
Dangerous funk.
That's when the funk get dangerous.
That's when you get a funky child.
Yo,
funky,
no funky child.
Yo, that's the name of this episode, y'all. I ain't gonna lie to y'all. Funky
up. That's a fact.
Funky up. Damn, man, this project was really good.
Yeah.
It was good to hear Mac Miller, man.
Oh, yeah, facts.
He sounded real good on that.
Yeah.
Damn, man.
Hell yeah.
Sad to see him go, man. It was a great song, man. Great song. Yeah. Mac does well on those songs too, man.
Oh yeah, that's his vibe. Was his vibe. For
yeah,
sure.
That's his bag. The project is pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
K Tronada, how we feeling on that, man?
I only was listening to it one time.
Oh, you listened one? Okay.
Yeah, I only got to it once, to be honest. So I don't remember much from it right now at the moment. But I know I like the Sir song.
Sir song was amazing. Go DJ. That's your hall. That's a jam.
Yeah.
Come on now.
Yeah.
Oh, where we at, y'all? Oh. My son said I like Sir on this something like that. I didn't think Sir could do something like this, but he did that shit.
He did
something.
He did.
Come on. What? Come on, go DJ. Come on, don't do that. Come on, man. Go DJ, man.
Talk to him, Sir.
Yo, my favorite song here, though, man.
What is it?
Song Vexo with Golink, man.
Oh, yeah.
Even though he on some stupid shit.
Yeah, he on some nut shit. But
he on some nut shit, but.
That shit is a bop.
Is a bop.
Yeah, it is.
And that's my problem with, like, music nowadays. If that shit ain't on the radio, I don't get how music works.
Because
that shit is great.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? This song, what? Come on, y'all. I know y'all tired of that Afrobeat shit, but I ain't even like that no more, son. There's a vibe right
they
here.
Who tired of Afrobeat? Niggas tired of Afrobeat?
It kind
of
is like,
we said they tired of it. Like, who tired of it? Like
I was like, they tired of Afrobeat from, like, not Afrobeat artists.
Right,
you feel what I'm saying?
Sure.
Like, they tired of that sound, like, you know, Drake Party course, and all course, that shit like course. That. People tired of it. But I never get tired. I like sounds like that. I like when we get into our, like, African bags. We are African.
Yes.
As much so as we are American, yes, we are African as well, African-American.
Mm-hmm.
It's not only important to know our American history, but it is very important to know our African history.
True.
You know, mm-hmm. I was watching Dr. Umar Johnson on Breakfast Club randomly, too. Like, he just, like, I didn't know he was on it, but he just on it recently. And I was like, damn, the brother is like, I was having a conversation with a friend of mine last night, and she was like, no, I said, yo, I kind of wish I could be this critical. Like,
about what?
Just about blackness.
Oh.
I feel like I'm very open about, you know, my stance with black people and shit like that and everything of that nature, but like, brother here is like, I don't know. I couldn't find a word last night. I can't find a word now. But it's just more like of like an impact when he speaks on his shit.
Mm.
And not to say that I don't leave impacts. I'm not sure how people view me. You know what I mean? I'm not sure if people are like, I mean, people tell me that, you know, I inspired them and shit like that. Like the platform that we created together, like, it's very inspiring to them and stuff like that. Like, us being open with our, like, where we stand and shit like that is cool and all, but
mm-hmm.
I don't know. Like, I feel like I could be doing a lot more and shit like that. You know what I mean?
True.
I mean, next year, listen, we planning on some things, man. I feel like especially around this time, next year, holidays, you should be giving away some turkeys. You know what I mean? I don't eat them, but I know there's families out there that need something. You know what I mean? So we're going to be doing a little bit more on the streets.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? But like, not more in that way though. I'm talking about just like as a voice perspective, like, yo, how to, like, you know, it's like naming heroes and then giving the history of, about them after. Like, you know what I mean? Like, he does that a lot, and I kind of wish I was like on some accord. Like, I mean, I read the same books he does. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I just, like, I don't recite information as well as I would love to. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Anyway, listen, it's good to know your African heritage, y'all, because so you can never get tired of saying.
In her eyes, found something I like, yeah. Weren't even my type. In a lie, in a lie. We had drinks all night. Put my phone on silent, and I don't know why. No, I couldn't leave her. Should've said bye, Felicia.
At this point in the party, you already spotted who you want to dance with. I wish
you had. Oh, they spotted him already?
You already spotted who you want to dance with. Now it's on you if you're going to go up to her or not.
What you going to do? What you doing?
I mean, if you spot her,
yeah.
And that's how you feel. Walk over there with your drink. You know what I mean? Why you bouncing and shit?
Oh, you gotta bounce.
You gotta bounce while you walk. You know what I'm saying? You gotta bounce while you walk.
Bounce while you walk. Let me see. Hey, I see you. I mean, hey.
Walking over to her.
Uh-huh.
Arms out like that.
You know? Oh, yeah.
So you open.
So you open. You open with it. You open. Yeah.
So like, I'm coming in. Don't gotta feel threatened. I just wanna dance with you. You know what I'm saying?
Fact.
I'm gonna dance. And hopefully you gonna dance back with me.
She gonna dance.
Then I might grab you if I might grab her.
Yeah, if she moving her hips.
You gotta grab.
She moving her hips. It's funky. She funking it up.
She funking it up.
So you gotta funk it up.
Now we gotta funk it up.
You gotta funk it up.
We gotta funk it together. Let's go.
And let's get it.
Funk it up. I just wanna
get behind you on the dance floor. Hey, you hear what he said? You hear what he said?
Exactly. I'm always coming handsome, then I hand rub, throw tantrums. If you leave me, that's it. Lord, no lie. When I ride on that beat, I just try to supply, gonna be good. Thank you, and even care, but I'm endo. Rip good, but I think I'm an asshole. Fuck me good, then I fuck so long that the moon and the sun's true position is sick.
Nigga said I fuck so long. Say, I ain't gonna promise y'all that, ladies.
I'm not gonna promise you that.
I ain't gonna promise you that.
Don't look for that.
Man, I ain't gonna be fucking solo.
Yeah, come on.
It's gonna be.
Come on. The funk can only last but so long.
Yo,
I mean,
funky it up kind of do hurt your hips.
You know what I'm saying?
You get that real funky shit.
Facts.
I feel like niggas got specials. You feel what I'm saying? Like, it's like you get the momentum.
Yeah.
And then the special, it's like a fight. It's like a game. Yeah, you know what I mean? Yeah, yeah. Then the special come on. Bang. Right.
Facts.
Then you get on hyperdrive or whatever you got. The slow strokes, the long strokes, whatever you niggas got. Right? And then you get in there, probably got 3 minutes. 2 to 3 minutes probably tops doing that special, and then it's back to that regular stroking and shit. Till you work that shit way up, unless you come, then it's a wrap. Then, nigga.
Yeah,
you know how to go.
What can you do?
That shit hard. But anyway, the song with Tinashe is hard too as well. Pharrell Williams did his thing, of course. It's a great project, y'all.
Yeah,
suggest y'all go check that out. K Trinata, Bubba,
love it.
Stormzy dropped, but you don't listen to Storms.
I don't.
It's a great project.
Yeah.
16 songs, 54 minutes.
Oh, wow.
Great, 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 great project. Can't speak highly enough on it.
Wow.
Great project, yo. Stormzy, goddamn. Did it again. Great artist, man. Phenomenal. Yeah, you know, those UK grime artists kind of hit or miss on them a little bit. But you got Dave last shit was cool. And then you got Skepta. Skepta be falling off. Mm. I don't know what happened to him, but he's not giving me what I need. Mm-hmm. That's unfortunate. I do got a new artist, though.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I don't know if you want to do it now.
I mean, dude, is it time for it?
Probably. Now, let's get into Aaron Ray. You know he dropped.
I know Aaron Ray dropped. I didn't hear it. I never got to Aaron Ray yet.
Tell me if you feel this right here.
Okay.
Sleep. What? This relationship's getting to me. Yes. Try my best to keep all of the peace. Trying, y'all. Yeah, my patience been taking some heat. Facts. So I'm weak by the end of the week. Try my best to explain what I've been on. Facts. When you're never gonna listen to me. Consistently try to compete. Yes. I'll just play your games if you want me to.
Hey,
I'll just play your games if you want me to.
Hey,
I'll just play the field if you want me to.
Hey,
I'll just play your games how you want me to. Me too, me too. Yeah.
Ooh, I ain't been getting no sleep. This relationship getting to me. It's my shit, Aaron Ray, boy. Yo, Aaron Ray, you invited on this pod, my nigga. Let's get it, man. Come on,
yo,
sit down with
through,
us.
Come through, Aaron Ray.
Come on,
through,
sit down
Aaron
with
Chan.
Us, man. Come on, man. I ain't been getting no sleep. That's my shit, bro. I mean, every other song on this shit you heard, you know, besides the Get Down. I don't know if he released a single, but I don't know if you heard that one.
It's a dance.
It's another dance shit.
It's a dance joint.
Oh, this is how we going. I think this is the vibes you on today, right now.
Oh yeah.
Come on, y'all.
Oh yeah.
I'll be yours, you'll be mine.
I don't think people dance to music like this no more. That's a problem.
No.
We don't like, you know what I mean? Like, it ain't no like.
No, yeah.
Snap of the fingers, two-step.
Everybody just does the new viral dances. You know what I'm
yeah,
saying?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
If you can't hit your woe with your milli rock to it, niggas don't want to
hear that shit.
Niggas
don't want to hear
that
shit.
You know what I'm saying?
That woe shit is not even a dance move for real.
That's what I'm saying. Like, you know what I'm saying? That's good for a certain time.
Exactly.
Like. But, like, to shit like this, niggas don't move their feet.
They're not moving their feet.
They move their shoulders. And definitely don't got no funk.
This is a funk move right here. This is funk right here.
Niggas stiff in the hips.
Oh, come on. Funky it up, ain't right.
Niggas are stiff in the hips. You can't funk this shit up.
Dance for me.
Hey.
Feel the heat. Oh, got to move your body.
Move your body.
Hands for me.
Move your body, hands and feet.
What you saying?
Feel the heat, y'all.
Feel the heat.
Hold hands for me. See, when you hold hands at the same time, while y'all dancing, special.
Yeah.
That means you care for the person.
Yeah, for sure.
It's a different type of care.
For sure.
Because niggas don't hold hands.
Yeah, I already told you last week.
Yeah, your hands.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you know, holding hands, whatever. We don't got to get into it, but holding hands ain't it. Like, if you're not in a relationship. That's what I'm going to let y'all niggas know. Anyways, I ain't been getting no sleep. That little EP that Aaron Ray dropped is great. The man can't miss. I don't understand why. Not to say I want him to.
True.
But the man doesn't miss. So, Bari, how's your week been, man? I'm not going to get into it yet.
My week, let's talk about last week. We was outside last week.
We was outside, what we here?
After the pod, you know what I mean? After the pod.
We do.
First week we went to let's shout out Queso first. Let's shout out our brother Kev.
Oh yeah, shout out Kev. I forgot we did that
for his release event. You know what I'm saying? Congrats to that. First of all, congrats on you for putting the album out and having an event.
Congratulations.
You know what I'm saying? Having the people that came out come out and support.
For
you
sure.
Dig? I ain't seen nobody from Adidas there, don't y'all niggas.
Yeah, yo.
I ain't seen nobody from Adidas there.
That you know. Never mind.
You know, I'm
that's terrible.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
that's terrible.
That's all I'm gonna say about that.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Niggas is funny. You know what I mean?
Niggas is funny.
I'm not speaking for Kev because I don't know if he expected anybody to come from Adidas. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But we was all there to get together.
Yeah, exactly.
And like we know, like we all fuck each other. We know people who fuck with Kev.
I felt like we all fucked with each other while we was working at Adidas. Like,
you know what I'm saying?
Some different level shit. But like you know, as new information has been coming to me, I don't see that. You know what I mean? So hey, you know what I mean? We ain't gonna call no names, but just know
the vibes.
Just know that we know the vibes.
Know the vibes.
We know the vibes. And to that same person too, man. You shout out a pod. Fuck it, I ain't gonna get into it. Yeah, I ain't gonna do that. My bad.
Yeah,
my bad.
Shout out to Kev.
Yeah,
though.
Shout out to Kev.
And shout out to all the artists that performed as
well. Yo, you know a nigga about to be shady.
Shout out to all the artists that performed as well, because I feel like they curated that shit well. I feel like everybody was like in the same kind of vibe.
In the same pocket.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like it wasn't like two left from the other. Yeah. Like, it was all together. And shout out, I think her name is Tana. She was fire. I was vibing her shit the most.
Yeah, her shit was fire, yeah.
Like, I downloaded her album, like her shit is tight.
Yeah, it's tight.
Yeah, I fuck with it. But yeah, shout out to everybody that performed though. And what we did before that though? Can we shout out?
I don't know if we can shout that out.
That's what I'm saying.
That's a little thing. But like,
that's what I'm saying.
Woman's I guess we can shout the show because it's on YouTube.
Oh sure.
Woman's Warrior Woman.
Warrior Woman. Yeah.
Warrior Woman on YouTube. We went to like a little viewing
sure.
thing of the new episode of new season to come up in New York. you know, somebody that I know is in it as well.
Yep.
So definitely had to support that. I think it's a great, thing they're doing.
I think so too. It looks good.
Yeah, woman of color, explaining their stories, not even on no preachy shit, just like something that could probably help whoever listens to it, like to let them know that, like, yo, I'm not alone in my struggle. You know what I mean? And I think it's important. I think that's something that's needed.
Word.
And you know, it's inspiring too, because it's going. I'm about to head to Barbados soon.
Yes.
Next week. So you know, that's why this is going to be the last episode. But we're going to do it during the week before I leave, you know what I mean? And I'm going to post the episode while in Barbados. I'm talking about that's work ethic right here, y'all.
It is.
We're going to do it. Yeah. But I just definitely wanted to shout out the fact that, you know, somebody is creating platforms for, like, women of color to broadcast their stories. And not no celeb shit either, just people, like, everyday people. And I think that's important.
Yeah.
And inspired me, though, because I am going to Barbados. So I will be taking something with me, like a camera or something like that. So I'll probably use my phone, sure, tripod, and then just, pew, and like, just like record some people.
Yeah.
Little 10-minute clips and stuff like that. And some people in Barbados, like, sit down, interview with them, and talk to them about how it feels to be, I guess, What's the culture like? Is it different in Barbados in terms of racism?
Right.
In terms of colorism, in terms of things like that, you know? Even speak about the culture. Like, is the culture different here? Which is obviously it is, but I don't think people know that.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? I don't think people might think that it's totally different, but it could be very much well be the same. You know what I mean? So, like,
right.
I think it's important to, like, you know, dive into that. So I will be doing that as well. So I am on vacation, but no, we will not be, like, we won't stop working.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? This is what we do out here, man. It's a living black. We're going to do something different besides the pod, man. We get into different areas of this, I guess, I don't even know what to call it.
I mean,
maybe media, I don't know.
Sure.
I mean,
we're creating our own thing. I mean,
we're doing our shit.
And shout out to her for supplying the medicine. You know what I'm saying?
Who?
You
was high. You was smacked.
Man, that was a nice night I had. Man, I ain't gonna hold you. I'm not gonna lie. Like, while we was chilling, you was playing Benny.
Yeah.
And like, something was coming over me. Like, listening to Benny while I was
high.
You know what I mean? In that state of mind, like, I was really, like, sitting there almost getting emotional. Like, if I wasn't such a thug, I would have cried. Like, that ass. Like, I held it together, but, like, it was all hitting me at one time, and I was just sitting there with my hands over my face.
Yeah, I saw that.
I just, like, couldn't understand what was happening. Like, the moment was almost too much for me.
The way that Benny was rapping, he was getting to you.
It was, like, I really, like, I felt it in a different level. Like, I've never sold drugs. I've never even came close to it.
Nah, right.
But, like, the way he was just talking to me was like, yo, like, it was like I was there with him.
Yeah.
And I almost cried. I ain't gonna lie. I almost cried. I was feeling it.
Did you see Benny on Sway in the Morning Freestyle?
I did. Yes, I did. Of course I did. Come on.
Yeah, I definitely watched that shit. I was like,
bro, this guy, Benny.
Bro,
it's too easy for this nigga.
The way he was just stopping, giving like a couple bars.
Exactly.
Stop, like. Stop, man.
He says, chapter to this. I said, all right, don't do this to me. Yo, and Conway, too. Conway spit on that shit.
He did, man. No, Conway just wanted to rap, man. I fuck with them niggas, man.
They just want to rap.
You know what I mean? And West Side Guns the Fly Lord. You know what I'm saying? Like
Conway was just like, he was like, oh, he's like, oh, so Sway was like, oh, you get into this? Yeah. I was like, all right, this shit about to be crazy. Yeah, I just want to hear them raps, huh?
That's a fact.
Like, I already want to hear another project.
Yeah.
Yeah, me too. It's coming soon.
It's coming. Like Benny, I think Benny dropping next. Top of the year and shit like that. I know Royce the 5'9" dropping.
Yeah.
Probably January or Feb. It's gonna be a good year for hip hop.
I hope so.
Next year, I think.
I hope so.
I think way better. You know, I was talking about this yesterday. Realize it's great 1 year, drop off next year. It's like it's stuff like that. It has to be.
Mm.
Right? So 2016 was a phenomenal year.
Sure.
2017 was trash. I can't remember what dropped in 2017. 2018 was great or good. And 2019, which is this year, obviously, is god awful.
Yeah, it wasn't good at all.
And then you got 2020. I think 2020, like you got Rihanna, you got I said Kanye. What am I talking about? What am I doing? That's over for Kanye. I'm sorry. You got Rihanna, you got probably Beyonce, you probably got Jay, maybe you got Kendrick.
For sure, Kendrick, I hope.
You got probably possibly Cole.
Oh, Cole for sure. That's confirmed.
That's confirmed. So, you know, you got
Drake, of course.
Most definitely.
Yeah.
So you got like you know, you got heavy hitters.
You gotta start a new decade right.
The baby, you know, he was actually having this conversation again. You don't gotta touch on artists of the decade right now. But I was saying, who might be the artist of the who might be the next artist of the new decade?
The next one.
So we was talking about discussing it 2020 to 2030. I was saying, look, yo, the baby has a huge chance.
He does,
right? Like a huge chance because he performs really well. He makes great music.
Yes, that he does.
Even though like some shit sound the same, the man makes great music. You feel what I'm saying? Like I think when he progresses as an artist, watch out.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, watch out. Yeah. So, like, I think he dropped, like, 2 albums this year, too, right?
Yes, he did.
So, like, this, like, if he consistently drops an album every year, which I think he should, like, on some Drake shit, that's what, like, fuck it. That's what makes Drake, to me, the artist of the decade.
Oh, it's not even a debate.
Yeah, exactly. Well, people trying to debate.
I don't believe you could debate that, really. Truthfully and honestly, you can't debate that Drake is the artist of the decade.
You can't because he dropped every year, and every year was a hit.
My nigga, he's dominated in every field, bro. He has the most hits in history.
Yeah.
In history of rap.
Yeah.
And almost in history of music. He's getting close to the history of music too.
Yeah.
Like that ass. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like in this past 10 years he did that. So like it's no debate. You know what I'm saying?
No debate. Yeah.
It's Drake.
I agree.
It's Drake.
And he's just consistent with the music. I think the baby though has that chance though. You know what I mean? May possibly like Lizzo, possibly her. You know what I mean? But like if the right team is behind them, I don't really like Lizzo music. I don't really listen to her as much. But I'm talking about like you know the mass.
Sure.
People listen to Lizzo. Like people listen to her. I mean, she has a real huge fan base. I love her performances. I always watch her performances. I think she's drop dead gorgeous. I think she's beautiful. She's fire to me. I just don't personally too much love her music. You saw her shaking her ass in the Lakers game?
I did.
How you feel about that?
But when I first saw it live, I was like, oh, wow, that's interesting. I wasn't expecting all that, you know what I'm saying? I thought it was just a bit extra, to be honest. You know what I'm saying? I thought it was extra. And, like, I wouldn't want my bare ass sitting on, like, public seats.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I just thought it was extra. You know what I'm saying? It was just for show.
How you feel about people saying that?
I wasn't offended, though.
Yeah,
like,
I wasn't.
Niggas was, like, really, like... I'm like, they was like kind of like up in arms about it. I'm like, it's not that serious. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
Like, Lizzo, I think, is definitely a bit of an attention seeker, though. You know what I mean?
You believe that?
Oh, yes, I believe that 100%. You know what I mean? I think she definitely kind of just overdoes it for the cameras a little bit. But I'm not bothered by it, though. You know what I mean? Because I don't pay attention to Lizzo like that. So it doesn't, I only see it like if, I mean, it just crosses my timeline. I don't go searching for Lizzo shit at all. So it is what it is. I don't care too much, but I definitely think she puts it on though for the cameras. You know what I mean? She definitely puts it on, which is fine. I mean, she's in that position and she could do whatever she wants.
Yeah, a lot of people was offended. Like you said, I ain't give a fuck.
Yeah,
it was attention seeking, but like you know, I don't know if she wanted. I don't know what the fuck she wanted, man. She responds to it. I hate when niggas. You know, what I hate when ads come on when I try to press a video. Just don't play ads.
Gotta play ads, man.
You gotta get that money, right?
Yeah.
She did say, though, I stay in my own positive bubble. I'm just curious on what. Let me see what the fuck she said.
What she said? She spoke
on. We love that little tiny purse moment. And you just said, you know I like to have fun, Gail. Well, guess what? We like to have fun, too. Anthony, will you do the honor since you're sitting so close?
Wait, we thought you needed a little cup to go along with your little purse.
Her laugh is crazy.
CBS this morning, mini cup. Yes. And we got one, too.
Yes. Yeah, there's 8 ounces of coffee in here. How'd you do that? Cheers.
Cheers.
Toast to you.
Lizzo is bad. I ain't going to hold y'all, so she bad.
So interesting.
Mad pretty. She's almost nasty.
So 8 Grammy nominations.
What do you put in the little bag, though? Like, what do you put in that shit? Like do you put anything in that little bag?
A little bag? She got a little bag for
him? Yeah, that little tiny ass purse.
All right, oh, yeah. They gave her a cup for that.
Like the size of a keychain.
I mean, I've been a successful musician, a touring musician for a long time.
Yeah.
I was an indie artist. I had my own label. I got signed to an imprint at Atlantic, and I was good.
Uh-huh.
I was like, this is great. I'm a career musician.
Yeah.
I have a fan base. I'm selling out tours. I'm good. My wildest dreams have been realized.
You would have been happy with that?
Happy with that.
So how would you describe what happened?
It's this thing that a year-old girl was like, the baby of her family was like, I have to take care of my mother.
Yo, you think she was the baby? I saw her at the baby show.
Together?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know. I have no idea.
I find that like hella, like she was at the baby show in New York on some random shit. Maybe not random. But it just was just like, yeah, the baby slapping that shit. That would be hilarious to me, bro.
You saw a video of the baby jumping to that girl's arms in the store?
Nah, I didn't see that.
there's a video that came out like the other day. It's like a fan of the babies.
Yeah.
She's a big girl.
Mm.
You know what I mean? And like the baby dead like ran and jumped into her arms. he said, yo, carry me to the Gatorade.
Like, she carried him
a little bit. I was like, yeah, I'll fuck with the baby. So this nigga is so real and funny, dog. Like he jumped into her arms and she held him up too. You know what I mean?
He likes big women.
Oh, he does. He definitely does. He definitely does.
Listen, man, you gotta respect
him. I'm not mad.
That's the thing that drove me to continue
unapologetically yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Which leads me to the Lakers game.
There we go.
Leads me to the Lakers game. Because the people are talking about you. So I want to know. I was
Yo, she had looked around, right? She had, when she used to lead me to Lakers, she's like, ha ha ha. Mm-hmm. Like she looked at her PR, like, yo, why is this bringing up
for real?
Why is this brought up right now? Like, don't bring this shit up, nigga.
A conversation with my friend Wendy this morning, who said,
shout out to Gail.
She's an entertainer. She's always on. That's just her personality. She's a performer. Other people say, okay, Lizzo, we get it. You're proud of your body positivity, but you're at the Lakers game enough. With your butt hanging out.
Okay.
What is your response to that?
Because
you've heard some of the flack that you've been getting about
not
it.
Not really.
Okay, well, let me tell you.
I stay in my own positive, you know.
So you don't even take it all in?
Well, it's their opinion. So,
okay.
I mean, it's not for me to really ingest. It's for them to express and for me to choose to listen to or not.
Or not.
You know,
was that a spontaneous moment?
Yeah, it absolutely was. I think no one would have ever saw what I was wearing, like the back of it, if I didn't get up and dance. And the Lakers girls came up to me and said, we're so excited that you're here. We want to perform one of your songs for you. And I remember I was sitting there and I was with my manager and my friend, and they were like, you should get up and dance. Like, they're doing this for you. And I was like, all right. Uh-huh. So I got up and I just did what I always do.
Yeah.
Anyone who knows me knows that this is how I've always been. This is how I've always liked to dress. And it took
me
a long time.
But did you forget your butt was out?
Her laugh is so fake to me. Like, why she did that?
She putting that shit on.
She putting that shit on. Mm-hmm. Like, one of my coworkers said too. Like, yesterday, because I mentioned that she could be artist of the decade next year. I mean, well, next decade.
Mm-hmm.
And then he was like, Lizzo, mad corny, cornball, throw her out. Hey, yo, like I'm talking about like terrible. Like, throw her out. Ah,
throw her out.
Yeah.
Cancel her?
Not cancel her, but just like she's just corny.
Corny?
I was gonna mention Drake. Like Drake is corny too, but
oh, sure, 100%.
But Drake makes great music. I'm sure Lizzo makes great music too, but
yeah, you could be corny and great.
Yeah, I mean
you can.
It's possible. You could be Drake.
You know what I'm saying?
But I think that's a once in a blue moon shit.
Sure.
Because Drake is Drake.
100%.
You feel what I'm saying?
For sure.
I don't find Lizzo corny. This right here though is too much. Like that ha. And then stop laughing. That's some Kanye shit for real, though.
Ridiculous.
Come on now.
That's what I'm saying.
I'm just curious.
I had on layers down there. So my it wasn't just, you know, flesh to seat.
Oh, okay.
You know, a lot of contrary to popular belief.
Uh-huh.
But, yeah.
So she had layers. She had something on her seat.
Yeah.
She had something on her seat?
You've talked about success like this.
And you're okay with it being out. Okay.
She did it.
Nigga, why you keep asking her the same shit? She okay. Yeah, she cool.
It sounded like Gail was offended. You know what I'm saying? I think Gail was offended.
Yeah, Gail was offended.
That's what it sounded like.
Yeah.
Come on, Gail.
Come on, man.
Leave those
You know how that is, right?
Yeah, come on, man. I hate when they do that shit, man. Don't do that shit. Come on, don't do that shit. I love that Drake. I feel like Drake gave the nod to DaBaby too.
Oh yeah,
on that performance in Toronto. Mm-hmm. Like, yo, doing your shit. So, yo, I'm telling you, DaBaby really might be. He's potential. He's potentially like could be an artist of the decade, next decade.
It's possible.
That's all I want to give there.
Sure.
What was you talking about before that?
We was about to get into, I guess, the OnlyFans.
Oh, shit. All right, so, Bari, guys, you had posted something in the chat.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Lovely.
Quite.
I ain't going to hold you. I was like, I wouldn't be mad if you did that, your damn self.
Quite lovely. She was quite lovely. You know what I'm saying?
Fire.
And I basically said, yo, like, you know what I mean? Because I be perusing through the gram or whatever.
Same.
You know what I mean? I run into a whole gang of these IG models pages. And always, you know, they say swipe up or sign up for exclusive content.
I always swipe up, too.
I always swipe up.
Knowing damn well.
I'm going to swipe right back down, but I'm going to swipe up just to see. You know what I'm saying? Just see, like, how many shits you got up there and, like, how much you asking.
Yeah.
And I'm telling you, like, as the day goes on, I'm getting closer and closer to sign up for somebody OnlyFans. I'm not going to hold you. Like, it got to take the right one.
Nah, yeah, that girl you said yesterday.
I'm getting this closer. I ain't going
to hold you. Because I had shit $9.99 a month. I'm like, that ain't too bad.
Nigga,
like
what?
That's like a... But I'm like, yo, like, I can't do it. Yo, I did the same thing, though. I said, yo... Whatever. Mm-hmm. I had sent that shit. It turned out to be a scam.
Right.
But I was like, yo, bro, like niggas, this like if I just made that move on some like, and I can't bring it to myself.
Me either.
I can't bring it to myself to be paid for these bitches.
That's
like,
what I'm saying.
For real, son.
I can't do it.
I can't bring it to myself. I don't, listen, I'm not shaming no nigga for doing that shit.
Of course
for sure not.
Of course not.
I just can't. Like, and I think women get into OnlyFans too, like for guys, because some guys got OnlyFans pages too, I guess, or whatever.
Yeah.
Or guys get into guys, whatever. But I cannot bring it to myself to be paying for something like that. So I can't. I don't even pay for, I wouldn't even pay for porn, like Brazzers.
That's what I'm saying. You can find all that shit on the internet for free. You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm saying. And a lot of OnlyFans videos be on like porn sites too and shit.
Sometimes, yeah, mostly.
You know what I'm saying? But my thing is like, all right, so like you already on your gram showing like nipples, a whole bunch of ass, right?
Yeah.
So if I sign up, I need to see like, something crazy.
Yeah. You need to see you squirts. Know
what I mean? Bro, if I'm giving you my change, I need to see something strange. You dig? Like, I need to see things in action and motion. I need to see something crazy that is not allowed on Instagram.
Yeah.
Don't be on Instagram and just show me a nipple.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Or like, you know what I mean? A little ass, maybe.
I see all that.
Every single day on the gram, I see nipples.
I
want
to see you
that.
Bend over or not. I want to see way more than that.
Come on now.
Squirts and
come,
all that.
I mean, I, come on now.
Yeah.
Bring a friend in, you know what I mean?
This is a woman named Miss B Nasty.
Hello.
She be masturbating in public.
Wow.
But her videos is divine. Wow. Divine. I'll be saying. I be catching on porn, I be catching on Tumblr, and I'm like, yo, I'm this close. Her videos is divine, bro. I ain't gonna hold you. Oh my god. I ain't gonna lie, son. I don't blame y'all niggas, man. I really don't, sir.
It's gonna take the right one. It's gonna take the right one. I don't wanna do it for just like no like regular like IG drama. It needs to be like somebody.
Nah, so he like bad.
Like some, you know what I'm saying? Somebody who like I wanna see in that light, but like don't give us that. You know what I mean?
What if Brian Miles had one?
Brian Miles, that's a good one. It's a good one.
That's a phenomenal one. You dumb.
Brian Miles,
you know who that is?
Of course, no, Brian. Come on now.
I know.
Drake gets introduced to Brian Miles.
He did.
You know what I'm saying?
Yo, nah, Brian Miles had one. I would die.
She been bad for 10 years.
She been bad for. Yo, I feel like she don't age, though.
It don't look like it.
I don't think she aged.
It don't look like it.
And she vegan, so that could help. You know what I mean?
Like, I don't want to be on and just start saying names and shit. You know what I mean?
Well, what you mean?
Imagine, like, you know what I mean? Like, Dylan Gonzalez. I mean,
you talking about those twins?
Yes.
Oh, my God.
I'm signing up.
Yo!
The fact that is, I ain't even mad at you, man.
I better stop. It got people like that. You
know what
I mean?
Nah, yeah, I ain't mad at you. People on that like one. That one. I'm signing up. That one, I'm with you on. Cause that shit is crazy.
Y'all out of your mind.
That shit is crazy. It's too much for me.
Got me funked up out here, man.
Rest in peace, man. Rest in peace to Juice WRLD. First of all, rest in peace to Juice WRLD. Do you know any information on the death? I thought he like was unhealthy or whatever like that or something like that. And when I first heard it, but when I got my hair cut, they was talking about it in the shop and they were saying that he had too much like drugs and fucking guns on the plane and
yeah,
he swallowed all the pills so yeah, he didn't get caught by the police on some right dickhead shit.
Yeah, apparently, like, you know what I mean, his entourage he was with or whatever, like, brought guns on the plane.
Yeah.
Along with 70 pounds of weed, which is crazy.
70 pounds of weed is ridiculous.
Like,
nobody needs that weed.
70 pounds of weed, that you have to believe that you're going to distribute that in a way, because you're not you and your mans ain't smoking 70 pounds of weed. So like that has you had. I would believe that you're gonna like try to sell that once you land or whatever.
Yeah.
Because like why you have 70 pounds of weed? That's an insane amount of weed to have. You know what I'm saying? So I think somebody like reported that him and his people had this shit on, so they called the cops.
Yeah, I'm gonna say it right now. Hip hop is mourning another loss on Sunday morning, December 8th. Juice WRLD unexpectedly passed away from a cardiac arrest in his hometown of Chicago. He just turned 21 on December 2nd. According to reports, Juice had just landed from a flight from Los Angeles at the Chicago Midway International Airport, where he suffered a seizure at the airport's private hangar. He was conscious when the paramedics arrived, but died a short time later at a nearby hospital. During the investigation, the FBI, that's kind of deep. During this investigation, the FBI say the word, man, for me. See?
What's the word?
Confiscated. 70 pounds of marijuana, a bottle of codeine cough syrup, 3 handguns on board his private jet after the pilot alerted authorities. Now, if we was talking about it in the barbershop or the salon, whatever, and one of the ladies said, like, yo, I would be telling too because I don't want my fucking license taken because of your bullshit and shit like that. I wish I wasn't aware of that your license could be taken if people have drugs on the shit. Like, what if I just didn't know?
Right.
So I could pretend I didn't see it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? If anything.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, the pilot was just doing his due diligence. You know what I'm saying?
I think so. I'm not mad at the pilot.
I haven't seen anybody who was either. I haven't seen anybody who was.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, law enforcement's reports Juice allegedly swallowed I can't pronounce those type of pills in an attempt to hide them, which may have led to fatal overdose as a cause of his death. Mm. Two of the rapper's associates was arrested for the weapons. Terrible.
That is crazy. That is really unfortunate. You know what I'm saying?
But like, if you think about it, man, this drug shit is ridiculous, bro.
Oh yeah.
This nigga had 70 pounds of marijuana. Do you know what a pound of marijuana is, bro?
Yeah, to have 70 pounds, that's what I'm saying.
That's like moving weight. Like, that's like you selling drugs now.
I would only believe that you was intended to sell that.
Yeah, like, why are you
like
moving?
Mass like,
yeah, mass distribution. Yeah, you know man. Yeah, yeah. Because who moves like that?
Like, that's insane. 70 pounds of weed is really crazy.
A bottle of codeine cough syrup and 3 handguns.
Bro.
You signed, like, yo, some of y'all people got like, yo. Yo, the brother was signed, bro. Signed. Moving like this.
Mm-mm-mm. And I believe that those guns may have been licensed too. Like, I think there was licensed guns, but okay, like you still there's like a process still to like travel with guns anyways, even if you're licensed.
Yeah.
So like I don't think they did all the paperwork, so like you're still traveling with guns. You didn't do the proper due diligence to travel with him. So, like, you was definitely going to get in trouble for it, even if there was licensed. You know what I'm saying? And so, I guess Juice WRLD got scared that So guns, weed, let me just swallow all these pills.
Yeah, because he didn't want shit to actualize.
You know what I'm saying? And that was unfortunately, it was fatal. It was fatal, which is unfortunate, man. It really sucks.
Yeah, it's really terrible. Never really like listen to the brother's music, but it's just sad to see another brother go from this hip hop shit.
Mm-hmm.
Another like, you know, black guy just like living out his like dreams and shit like that, and it's just sad to see him go over something like this. And that goes to show you that like yo, not even just artists, but yeah, young kids gotta stop just doing these crazy drugs, man.
Yeah, I don't know.
You don't look cool doing it for real though, honestly.
It isn't cool. Now I hope this new decade that we're about to enter in, we see a change. You know what I'm saying? Hopefully the narrative shifts.
We get back to like, yo, that shit ain't cool. Like, what are you doing?
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I really hope we stop losing. And anybody really, but like especially the young rappers, the young artists who like they all, and it's crazy, like, cause they all have, as soon as they come out, they have like this huge influence on kids.
Yeah,
as soon as they open their mouth, you know what I'm saying? It's like we need y'all around, you dig?
Yeah.
We need y'all around to, like, to preach something other than yo, let's pop pills, sip codeine type shit. You know what I'm saying? Like it sucks.
Yeah, man, it's terrible, man. Rest in peace.
It's been a rough year with that shit too, man. Been a rough year.
Been very terrible. Very terrible with the deaths we've had. That's what I'm saying. Like 2019 was a rough year. But on a lighter note, there's a lot of festivals going on. Mm.
Mm-hmm.
Did you see any?
Yeah, I saw the Pharrell joint. In Virginia Beach.
You got Dreamville.
And Dreamville in April, right?
Yep.
North Carolina. You know what I'm saying?
I'm telling you which one we should hit up is Something in the Water. That's for real shit.
Virginia.
Bro. ASAP Rocky. Baby Rose. Chance the Rapper. Clips. Earth Gang. Foo Fighters.
You said Clips too. That means Pusha and No Malice.
Oh yeah, come on now. Lil TJ, Metro Boomin, Migos, Major Lazer, Lil Tecca, Gunna, Her, Tyler Creator, Usher, Black, 070 Shake. Yeah, I know. I said Black. I'm not sure. Yeah, I fell asleep when I said Black. I almost snored.
Give him a nap.
Snow Allegra.
Come on now, Snow.
Shit. Tiara Whack. Come on, Tiara Whack. Where the fuck is the album at?
Yeah,
Tiara, where the fuck is? Come on.
She slowed down a little bit. Yeah.
Now she slowed down.
She slowed down.
Now she slowed down. She had the momentum when she was releasing.
Momentum, you know what I'm saying?
She was releasing those little videos, especially on Instagram. Man. Now you slowing up. Down. That's Pick my fucking problem up, with you, man.
Pick it back up.
Your girlfriend, Mariba.
Hey, boo.
Pop Smoke. Pharrell, of course. Playboi Carti. Post Malone.
Posty.
Oh, my God. Rico Nasty. Oh, my God.
Crazy.
Did I say Trey Songz?
No, you didn't.
Trey Songz.
Oh, Virginia. Hello.
Come on now. We out here, boy. Yeah. Leon Bridges.
Wow.
Come on now. Sheesh. Jaden Smith. You don't fuck with him, but I do. Damn.
It's a lot of people. You just
it's too much. And then, Buddy.
Oh, come on. I love Buddy.
Like, where do you fit all these niggas?
And not to mention Pharrell and his friends. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, Pharrell and his friends. Like, who's his friends? I thought they was all in here.
And last year, he brought out his friends for real.
Nelly. Nelly gonna set that shit out right.
Oh, come on.
Nelly can perform.
What? Sleeper hits, too.
Yeah, that you forgot about. OD.
My thing is, who's Pharrell gonna bring? Because last year, well, I guess this year, his friends were Hov, Snoop.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? JT, I think he brought out. Yeah, like, everybody's ever, like, made songs with, he brought out. So, how many more friends you got?
Friends you got?
Teddy Riley, I think he brought it. But Teddy Riley, like, how many more friends you got? You brought out Hov, man. In my opinion, it'll
get better than that.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Unless you're gonna bring out B. Unless you're gonna bring out B.
Oh, did he got something with B?
I don't know.
I mean, but if he bring out B, I'm with it.
But that is his friend, though. You know what I'm saying?
True.
Shit. Man, let's go bring out B. Rihanna? I don't know.
Because Rihanna shit might release it, and you don't know.
That's what I'm saying. Might get a song. Who knows?
Wale, too. Wale in the Backyard Band.
Yeah, is that the Wale? Like, is that Wale?
Let's look it up.
Because I've never seen Wale mention any Backyard Band. You know what I mean? I've never seen Wale perform, which is kind of interesting.
Do you want to see him perform?
I mean, I wouldn't mind seeing Wale perform. I've been a Wale fan, but it's my, you know what I mean, since the decade started. You know what I'm saying? Since he dropped, since he first came out. I love Wale. I don't think I've been interested really. You know, I'm not gonna hold you.
Yeah, I'm not interested in watching Wale.
I never wanted to like go to a Wale show, but like, I would though. But I don't want to pay for the ticket.
No, him in the backyard band.
That's it. Wow.
Yeah, like he performs with them.
What a backyard band! I never heard of
that. I think that's who he performs live with.
Oh, were?
Yeah.
Hi, Wale. Gappy.
Yeah, for Lawrence. Probably like a band from DC.
Hi, Wale.
So let's get it, man. Back. Wale. 2020, something in the water is about to be a special.
What time is that? What time of the year?
April 20th to 26th. Oh, that shit is a stretch. It's a whole fucking week.
That's a whole week. Because they got like mad.
They got mad
shit.
Artists. I mean,
it's a whole. Like, it's
not, oh yeah, because I see calls.
Yeah, like it's a whole thing. You know what I'm saying? It ain't just music. It's like a whole.
Oh, Pharrell got that shit. Oh, that's a movie.
A whole week. That's crazy.
That's a movie.
That is insane.
I don't even know.
How long we'll be there for? I don't know if we'll be there for a whole week. We won't be there for a whole week.
We have to see people.
You have to?
We don't have to, but like, what are we going to do? We can't just not see niggas.
So niggas, so for 6 days, niggas going to perform like every day?
See, that's one thing I got to know.
Yeah, I got to see the schedule, how that shit is.
You know, schedule won't pop up until like close to it.
I don't want to be in Virginia
for a week. You don't want to be in Virginia for a week.
For an entire week, though? Like, I'm not sure.
That shit's going to be crazy, bro.
The weather might be nice.
It's probably going to be a lot costly on the pockets, too, though, for sure.
That's what I'm saying.
Go and then to, like, stay there for a minute and then eat comfortably.
Yeah, we'll see what happens. We'll see what happens with that. I wouldn't mind being on the beach, though. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, for sure. 20 to 26. Damn, that's a minute.
It's a minute.
That is a minute. I'm going to Roots Picnic for sure. They didn't release nothing. But I'm going to Roots Picnic for sure this year.
Okay.
I need to see what that is.
All right.
Yeah. Well, how you feel about the Nick Cannon thing?
No, him and Eminem.
Yeah.
I haven't paid attention to it.
Me neither.
I'm sorry. I couldn't care less.
Fat Joe's album. Did you listen?
I did not.
Okay. There we go. We moving. We getting into it. That's all I got for y'all. That's all I got for y'all right now.
Yeah.
Like I said, it's supposed to be the last episode. It in fact, isn't. We're supposed to do the end of the year recap. We didn't, in fact, get it. Wednesday will be the end of the year recap. We're gonna get into it.
Mm-hmm.
We're gonna get real nice in it.
Yeah, it's gonna be special.
You got anything on your mind, bro?
Anything on my mind? No. No, I think
Bari doesn't have nothing in his mind. It's beyond me.
Oh my God, I don't think I do really. You know what I'm saying?
Macklemore released a Christmas song.
I saw that. I didn't listen, but I saw it.
Yeah, I'm not going to listen.
I'm not interested in Macklemore.
I don't know what he doing for sure.
The hell does Macklemore do still? He still makes music?
Yes. Really? Nigga said, does he still make music? Of course he makes music.
Nigga still like Macklemore?
Yeah.
He's still like a thing.
Yeah, he's still a thing.
Really?
Did you see the baby's performance on SNL?
Yeah, it was phenomenal. It was great.
Yeah,
great.
Then he could perform.
He could perform very well.
And he's swole.
Yeah, he's swole.
That's what the level you try to get into.
Yeah, I'm trying to get like that.
Trying to get into that.
Yeah, it's a good arc.
That's a good arc.
It's a good level arc. It's a good size.
A different type of arc though. You gonna be at least like what? You gonna be like 170?
Yeah, probably. Solid mass.
If you 170, that's ridiculous.
Solid mass, you know what I'm saying?
Solid mass.
You know what I'm saying? Like that with it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Pull up on you. Like
and they going to funky them up.
Oh, I'm going to funk you up with the ock.
The funky them up with the ock.
I'm going to funk him up with the ock.
Funky up.
Funky with my ock, you know what I mean?
Funky with the ock.
You know the vibes.
Yo, listen, man. If you don't know, now you know. I keep forgetting why I'm on YouTube. I'll be turning around shit.
Oh,
like
what's this? You got some 3000 Rick Rubin thing here.
What's that, 3,000 Rick Rubin?
Andre 3,000 Rick Rubin.
Oh, shit. Yeah. Andre 3,000 Rick Rubin. I saw them together pictured.
What they did?
Nothing. Oh. I just saw them pictured together.
Oh.
I assumed new music will be dropping.
Oh, is that what you assumed?
I assumed that, of course.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
I didn't assume that.
Andre 3,000 probably is going to have a new album.
I think so. 2020.
2020, 100%.
That's what we're doing?
Why would you be in? And he's like, there's a picture of him like right in front of like that trailer looking thing that Rick Rubin loves to be in front of. I saw him like interview Kendrick Lamar and shit.
Yeah, I just assume Rick Rubin was probably like talking to him, like interviewing him for something.
Oh, that could be the interview too. You know what? Because he did interview Kendrick. You're right.
He'd be interviewing niggas.
Yeah, you're right.
He sat down with Pharrell recently too. Rick Rubin did. Him and Pharrell had like an hour long talk.
I didn't see that.
In front of that same trailer, I believe.
I missed that one.
And Shangri-La. So like,
So that could be a sit down.
Yeah, I assume it was an interview.
Woo, fuck.
But I would love it if some music came out of it.
I think music should come out of it.
I think so.
I think Andre could release some music anytime he wants.
Like he definitely can.
Yeah, you know I mean, I think he's that special.
And I think we will get Andre album at some point. I think so. I mean, I low key have faith in that. Low key, I'm not waiting for it, but I think it will happen.
Yeah, exactly. You shouldn't wait for it, but like I think it will happen.
He wants to.
Yeah. It's only right.
I hope.
For now. Well, that's it. That's all I got on that list.
Yeah, that's all you got here.
That's all I got on the list. Yeah, all right, cool.
Hit these end of year joints.
All right. Yo, like I said, special love to everybody. Whoa. Selena Gomez reveals new album Rare featuring Kid Cudi and Black. Okay, fuck's a loop.
New Kid Cudi album next year.
Oh, yeah. I'm saying 2020 going to be special, bro.
It's going to be big.
Cudi album based on love. It's like a love project.
I'm ready for it.
Cudi could kill that shit. I just want to hear them hums.
I'm ready for it.
Anyways. Thank you guys for supporting us, YouTube. If you haven't yet, subscribe. If you haven't yet subscribed on Apple Podcasts, subscribe. If you haven't yet followed us or subscribe on Spotify, subscribe, follow, whatever that button says.
Mm-hmm.
Tune in every week. Check us out. There will be another episode on Friday the 20th.
Holiday special, you know what I'm saying? Right in time. Just in time for the holidays, you know what I mean?
Just in time for the
matter
holidays.
Matter of fact, save it for Christmas. Listen to it. Play White Way Opening Gifts and all that.
But we might be cursing in front of the family. I don't know.
Might be cursing?
Might be.
All right, so put the kids away then.
Put the kids away.
Have grandma take care of the kids.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? Have our shit playing while you're opening gifts, spend time with your family. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Or like just play on your travels when you're traveling this weekend.
You ever had sex at a podcast?
No.
Okay.
No. I don't believe I would want to.
I'm not saying you should. I'm just saying, like, what if you just get into the moment while you listen to a podcast?
That would be interesting, and like because it can happen. I mean, people listen to podcasts and then just shit just pop off. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I mean, now I think about it. Let me see if I have. I know situations where it could have happened. I don't know if it did.
Oh, you don't know if it did?
Yeah, but I don't.
Probably shut it off first.
Yeah, like, I don't believe. Like, I don't want to hear my voice.
Yeah. But you don't want to hear another nigga voice either.
I don't. I don't want to hear people like talking like that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like if it's not like a TV regular, I don't want to hear like voices in the back.
So like, what's the difference to a TV? Because I fucked the ESPN plenty of times.
Oh yeah, for sure. But I'm not paying attention to it though. Okay, I don't. Okay. Like it's just on. But yeah. I'm not really watching it. You know what I'm saying? But like voices, like I feel like I would hear.
You hear? Yeah.
Out of a speaker type shit. Like nah, I'm cool in that. You know what I mean? I don't want to hear niggas just talking. I want to hear niggas just like, you know what I mean, debating on like basketball or some shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, nah, I'm cool on that.
Speaking of basketball, shout out to Hood Center Podcast, feature of May 3rd. If you haven't yet, go check that out. If you love basketball, if you love sport talk, I enjoyed that episode a lot. Did you listen?
I didn't get to it, no. Yet. I didn't get to it yet.
It's just got on Apple Podcast. It's also on Spotify. Check them guys out, man. Those are my guys, man. Mm. Shout out to everybody.
Mm-hmm.
Let me see. What was I just saying, though? Oh, yeah.
Oh, you're fucking the podcast.
Yeah, man. Follow. But before you do that, support our shit first, man.
Facts.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Support our shit first. Let's get to this bag together, man.
Oh, yeah.
Let's move together. You know what the vibes is. Next year will be all great, all beautiful.
We get into the bag next year.
Oh, I, without a doubt, don't have a doubt in my mind that won't happen.
We get into the bag.
Get into the bag is gonna be special.
What size bag? I don't know, but it's gonna be a bag.
It's gonna be a little bag.
It's gonna be a little bag.
Little bag.
Got to up slow.
Yeah, for sure. We're gonna be gonna have some live shows. So hopefully you guys come out with us.
Pop out.
You know what I mean? Hit us in the DMs, all that.
Me my DMs.
Where would you like to see us at, man?
Mm.
We're gonna do like little small shits, 20.
Sure.
You know what I mean? A little 20 pop up.
Sure.
Yo, come through, man. You know what I mean? Let's chop it up.
Pop out. See really support out here, I'm saying?
Exactly.
See
I want support. I want to see some faces, man.
See really support.
I want to see some faces, man.
Mm-hmm.
Anyways, you about to get the hell out of here, man.
Let's get it. Let's get it.
What we tuning into? What we getting out of here with?
We getting out of here with? You know, I've been listening to a song recently on repeat off of Malibu. Anderson .Paak's first album.
Oh, okay, what is that?
Lightweight. It's just been in my head. I've been rocking it. It's more dance vibes, you know what I'm saying? We hit you with the dance vibes on the podcast. Might as well continue the method.
Gotta continue the method.
You know what I'm saying? Real funky. You know what I mean?
Oh, this is funky it up.
We gonna funky it up. We funky it up.
Funky it up.
All up in the groins, all up in the hips, you know what I mean?
All up in the groins is hilarious. Who says
funky out the dog?
Funky After Dark is hilarious,
bro.
Sometimes you got Funky After Dark. Can't have morning. Can't be funky in the morning.
I don't want to get funky in the morning.
Funky in the morning is nasty.
Yeah, in the morning my breakfast funky. You know what I'm saying?
So I'm cool with that.
Cool with what?
I'm cool with like your breath not being all the way there.
Oh sure.
Yeah, man.
Oh sure.
So I don't care about that shit.
Yeah, I don't trust you if like your breath smell good in the morning.
Why don't trust? Because they got just
cause
got
what,
up.
What does that mean though? Like yeah. why is your breath smell good on the wake up? You know what I'm saying?
Well, like you probably brush your teeth that night.
Maybe.
When I brush my teeth that night, I brush my teeth every night. Okay. But when you do it, like when you wake up, you don't. That shit not me. Like,
No, it's not. It ain't rank.
Ain't rank. See, I don't say that enough on the pod. I'm about to trademark that too.
Yeah, you gotta get rank off.
Rank. Gotta get that rank off.
Get rank off. You know what I'm saying?
Cause now niggas starting to like use my shit now.
Niggas using shit.
Niggas using my slogans, man.
Who's
nasty business?
Fuck the flow. They jacking our slang.
Oh, who's that?
Hove.
Okay. Nasty business rank. What else I say? God awful.
I think God awful is me personally.
But no.
God awful is me.
Do you say that?
Yeah, I do say that.
I can't remember you saying that. I probably got it from you. That's fine. So I got it from you. It is what it is. See how easy it is.
You know one thing you did used to say, or maybe you should say it, that like my mother picked up on like a while ago.
What?
You always used to say things of that nature. That's what she associates with you.
I never say things of that nature.
Yes, you do, bro. I don't even say it as often, but like you did it a lot at one point. Things of that nature. You told me, things of that nature.
I wonder if other niggas just be saying random shit too that just have like slogans, or is it just like a quite few that just be like having like punchlines that just of it? Because I just be saying random dumb shit.
Yeah, you go through Facebook like you just say like just like pick up on shit and just like hold on to it. You know what I'm saying? We all going through many phases. Just start saying shit.
I've been saying terrible a lot lately.
Is that right?
Yeah, like terrible.
Just terrible.
Just terrible. Not even just terrible.
Terrible.
Like I've been saying, I think I've been texting that more often than not.
Yeah?
Yeah, people have been mentioning, like, that's your new word. Like, might be, because a lot of shit is just terrible.
Yeah, the big facts.
Yeah, you know, music, terrible.
MTA,
yeah.
Terrible.
Yeah, oh, shit. Well, hey. That's why we got a new episode, man. We got a new episode next week, man. Like I said, the 20th.
A lot of game.
Friday, man.
Yeah.
I'll be in Barbados, but we never stopping. We going to do it.
No, dedication.
Dedication to this shit we call And Living Black, man. You already know the vibes. We love y'all. Follow us if you didn't know. At JD Opinionated is me.
At JSaint_ is I.
And at Living in Black is us. That's what we're going to do. We're going to get out to this lightweight.
The mic is still on?
Yeah.
He really can't funk without it, yo.
Every
time we bring you funk box. Funky it up.
We still out of here, y'all. Don't worry about this.